working in the coffee industry. It might be the case, like, you know, 4 years back, 5 years back, but right now I feel that women are working more and more in this industry. Yeah, even in Singapore, it's not a rare sight. So I think the uniqueness about this event is that it encourages women to compete in such competitions, because I've seen a few local competitions, and be it the AeroPress or the Latte Art or any of such, a lot of the competitors are male. Yeah, I was just discussing with Mira and Bessie as well. I'm like, why is it that a lot of the competitors are usually male? And they said that it might be the culture, that, you know, that the tradition that women kind of need to take a step back when it's a male-dominated industry, but it's no longer the case. This event, it just needs to get used to the idea that, you know, women are probably equal. I'm not too sure if I'm saying the right thing in this culture. That there is here in Jakarta or Indonesia, that it is more of a masculine career path. I think the ladies shouldn't be discouraged, because as we progress, as we grow and improve in this industry, I feel that women are in a better position as well. In an equally good position as men to excel in this industry. And there are many studies that show that, you know, women are better tasters. You know, women have better palates. Or like even Asian women too. Asian women have better, they did a study, have better palates. And that would definitely help if you're in this industry to be able to taste the food as better. So I mean, this is just like an encouraging note, you know. I'm not saying that everyone has got better palates, or that the study is true, because it can be false. But just saying that, you know, there's a chance that you can do really, really well and even better than a man. So don't be discouraged by the culture of it. And I think that everyone in Indonesia are getting to be more open and more trendy in such a way. So it can be a start for women.